The engineers at Ford took the Ranger through a series of four real-world tests, pushing it to its limits of torque, water, heat, and strength, proving it is tough done smarter. This is the science of tough. The Ranger is built to take on a wide variety of real-world conditions, from tough terrains to real deep water. And to prove that, the Ford engineers are here at this test facility to show how the Ranger's smart design delivers best-in-class wading capabilities.
Today we're going to take the Ranger through 200 millimeters of water at high speed. Then we're going to take the water level up to 800, which is best-in-class performance.
On our first round, the depth is not the only challenge.
200 doesn't sound like a lot of water, but at that speed, it's going to be like a hydraulic hammer.
Hitting unseen floodwater at 25 kilometers per hour could destabilize driving dynamics and seriously damage another vehicle. That's why the front end of the Ranger was designed to disperse the force of the water, keeping the wheels on the ground and the driver in control.
All of the seals are still good.
We've done our checks. Everything's passed.
That's the common water depth vehicles were built for. But the Ranger was designed for the extreme.
Above this guard is where we've actually got the air intake. This is what makes this car breathe. This has been designed to give Ranger 800 mil best-in-class water wading capability. The alternator was brought up. We've moved electrical components high up in the engine bay again. It's been designed to be tough.
The Ranger's smart aerodynamics work like a ship's hull, forming a bow wave that spreads the water away from the air intake as the truck cruises.
With a Ranger, we only call it a pass if we can do it with 1 ton in the back. The full capability of the Ranger at max payload.
Sitting lower, but it's still doing exactly what it's supposed to be doing.
As the sun begins to set, the engineers could be calling it a day, but they're not quite satisfied.
I'd like to try one thing else. I'd like to, if we could, back it in and let it idle in the water for an hour. That's something that we've never done before.
Once again, the Ranger slips into the depth no other truck can survive. But this time, for more than just a crossing.
Yeah, this is pretty crazy. This is nuts. We've got all sealed connectors that are watertight. We don't want water getting in there, otherwise there'll be pistons everywhere. The fog lamps would have been sitting down at the bottom there. High intensity, still working. This is just tough done smarter.
The Ranger's elevated air intake keeps the engine idling normal, proving to be ready for any kind of waiting situation.
That's 2 hours.
2 hours. Yeah, it's amazing.
Our engineers think ahead and go beyond your needs. So when it comes to the real world with its real rivers, real currents, and real obstacles, nothing surprises you. That's what we like to call tough done smarter.